And good evening. Three down, one to go this evening in the opening round of the Lincoln Thanksgiving Invitational. It's Lincoln and Ashville. We're tipping off and we're playing basketball from Golden Bear Land. Shot up and shot good for the Golden Bears, and with the early lead, Lincoln up 2-0. Quickly down the floor, this is Ashville, and putting up a shot is Antonio Pierce, and it is blocked. However, we got a foul on the play, and that will send Pierce to the line. Quickly for Ashville, the starting five tonight, number 13, Antonio Pierce. One is Hunter Huckabee, 14, Landon Cornett. Noah Cater is number 22, and Zarian Williams, the leading scorer, number 23, coming in averaging 16 points a game. Pierce first free throw is up and good. For the Golden Bears, Zay Caldwell, number two. Tyler Hemphill, number three. Malik Weed, number four. Quinn Carmichael, number 11. And D. Whiteside wears jersey number 12, the starting five tonight for both teams. Pierce hits both free throws and we're tied at two, opening minute here from Lincoln Gymnasium. This is the Golden Bears. Three-pointer in the air that is in and out, no good. That three-pointer put up by Malik Weed, it goes out of bounds. It will be Golden Bear basketball.
Lincoln 2-0 on the season. Ashville 1-1. Here's Hempfield, inbounded in to Caldwell.
And Caldwell knocks it down from three-point land, 5-2. Now the score on the three-pointer by Caldwell. Full court pressure by the Golden Bears. Ashville able to break that pressure, and down the floor, there's a three put up that is no good by Hunter Huckabee. The follow is no good. And the third try, that's Zarian Williams again coming in, averaging 16 a contest. His first basket of the evening. 5-4, the Bears on top by one. Ashville starting defensively in the zone. Lincoln able to get inside that zone and get the easy bucket. That's Quinn Carmichael for his first two of the game.
Quinn Carmichael, one of the eight seniors on this team. Good post move.
There's a steal by the Bears at midcourt. Quickly down the floor and creating offense off the defense. The layup by Hemphill and the lead moves to five.
Good steal by Quinn Carmichael at half court. Now another steal.
And a frustration foul. Back-to-back turnovers by Ashville created by this full court pressure being applied by the Golden Bears. And Lincoln will shoot two free throws as D. Whiteside will toe the line.
That foul is on Landon Cornett.
Two free throws for Whiteside. Five-point lead remains a five-point lead, and Whiteside will have one more.
Really, Ashville starts two sophomores, one junior, and two seniors.
Really been looking forward to seeing this Lincoln team play too, Jason. I've heard a lot of good things about these guys during the offseason. Of course, they're coming in, as you said, 2-0, and Rush Rutledge may have one of the best teams he's had in quite some time, the Bears.
Certainly one of the most experienced teams he's had with eight seniors on the team. You won't find another team in the area with eight seniors on the team, and that defense was able to get a 10-second turnover in the backcourt. Anytime you get that, man, that is huge. Good defense, full court defense by the Golden Bears.
I asked Russ Rutledge before the game tonight, I said, how many players do you rotate? He said, I dress 14 and I play 14. So that's quite a rotation. In and out, another follow-up. Still can't find the mark. They do now. That's Quinn Carmichael with two more. And the Bears off to a hot start here, up by seven.
Whiteside missed two inside. Carmichael there to clean it up. Easy layup for Pierce on the other end.
Yeah, got ahead of the press, and Pierce with two more to cut the lead back down to five. And there's a turnover on Lincoln. That is a carry by Hemphill, and will go the other way.
You see that called in high school. These kids watching the NBA game, they won't call that an NBA game, but you're going to get it if the ball rests in that palm. You're going to get that carrying call.
Ashville playing out of Class 3A Area 11 along with Glencoe Ohatchee and Westbrook Christian. Down the floor and two more by Malik Williams. And Ashville, when they beat the press, they're getting easy shots, Jason.
Carmichael on the other end. Shot up, no good, and getting fouled. But like you said, beating that press and getting an open look down there.
No, you and I called the first game of this tournament. That was the Winnebago Pell City game this afternoon. And I think it's safe to say the pace of this one is a little bit faster.
Yeah, a little bit more scoring earlier in this game than it was in that Winnebago Pell City game. The score after the first quarter was 12-9, so we've almost surpassed that here with 5:13 to go in the first quarter as Carmichael misses two free throws.
Missed them both, but second shot opportunity for the Golden Bears, and Whiteside in the paint for the easy two. And Ashville throws it away. Just 3 minutes into the basketball game. Already the Bears, you see it there, 13 points on the board. So a high-scoring team this year. They've been able to put a lot of points on the board and off to a hot start here this evening. Walking it up the floor, this is Malik Weed, the junior for Lincoln.
Ashville drops back into a 2-3 defense.
Now inside they go, and inside the lane, and two more put it on, write it down, that is, for the Whiteside, and the Bears move on top by seven. Full court pressure, and Ashville is able to beat it this time, but a near steal. They get it inside, two more. Ashville with beating the press, and Williams lays it in for the bucket.
It's the third time that Ashville is able to beat that press. Lincoln's put a lot of focus stopping them in the backcourt and leaving that man open underneath.
15-10 the score. And there's a turnover. Yes, it is. Ashville coming out of there with it, and we'll come the other way. This is Judd Mundy, and Mundy leaves it with Noah Cater. Cater out near the timeline. Ashville down by five. Under 4 minutes to go here in the opening period. There's a three in the air, and you can write it down. That's Zarian Williams, the leading scorer, and the lead's down to two.
Williams, one of the two seniors in this starting lineup, was able to knock that three-pointer down.
Good interior pass there, but unable to convert. Second shot opportunity, however, and the Bears move back on top by four.
8 points in the first quarter for Whiteside. So strong underneath the basket in the paint area. He gets the ball there. It's pretty much automatic 2 points, and Lincoln knows that, and they're trying to get him the ball as much as they can inside.
Williams leaves it with Cater. Cater drives. Now his bounce pass is kicked out of bounds. And we have a media timeout. 3:09 remaining in the opening quarter. It's the Bears on top by four. You're watching the Friday Night Network.
Welcome to Calhoun County, Alabama, your natural attraction. We have invigorating outdoor activities, amazing cultural sites, mouth-watering food, and southern hospitality all wrapped into one amazing vacation destination. Whether you're looking for a relaxing overnight getaway or for a one-of-a-kind escapade, Calhoun County boasts an incredible selection of outdoor recreational opportunities. Calhoun County is the natural attraction centrally located between Atlanta and Birmingham, with plenty of fun and memories waiting to be made. Come to Calhoun County, Alabama, a natural attraction.
Professional Apothecary has been the Talladega area's trusted hometown pharmacy for generations. We can meet all your prescription and insurance needs. Plus, you'll find all the basic over-the-counter medications. There's a full line of support hose, and don't forget to check out our Dollar Saver Shelf. When it comes to medical supplies, Professional Apothecary has you covered. You'll find everything from mobility needs to home and portable oxygen, CPAP equipment and supplies, easy lift chairs, and a full line of Dr. Comfort shoes.
Merry Christmas from Professional Apothecary.
Just off the square in Talladega.
3:09 to go, opening quarter, ready to resume play. Ashville basketball, side front court, down by four. Again, Lincoln just trapping all over the floor. This is Cater. Cater now goes left side. Mundy got a whistle and a foul. This foul will be on the Bears.
A couple of players in for Lincoln. LJ Carmichael also into the game. Isaac Davis, their first action of the ballgame.
Ashville again will trigger it in. Cater goes cross court and throws it to a spectator. It will be Golden Bear basketball as he'll bring it up the floor following the turnover.
Took out one of the Lincoln cheerleaders on about that third row.
But she was open.
Yeah. Also in the game for the Golden Bears, number 22, Dante Rivers. Number 35, Savion Woods.
Inside, looking for the entry pass in the post, and the Bears throw it away. Cater for three. Not this time. Ball is loose. It goes out of bounds. It will be Bear basketball.
D'Angelo Williams had that rebound, just lost it. Goes out of bounds. Another turnover for Sylacauga.
Winners on day one, the Pell City Panthers defeating Winnebago was Westbrook Christian over Moody. And White Plains just a moment ago defeating Sylacauga. This is the final game of the first session of the 2015 Lincoln Thanksgiving Invitational. Nearing the two-minute mark, the Bears with the ball up by four. This is Dante Rivers. Rivers goes right side against this 2-3 zone of Asheville. They swing it around the horn. This is Isaac Davis. Davis gives it right back to Trey Ellis. Inside the lane, his shot is partially blocked. Coming out of there with it is D'Angelo Williams for the Bulldogs. Down the floor, this is Asheville. They're in a trap. We got a whistle and a foul. This foul will be on the Bears.
Dante Rivers will pick it up. Thought he had the jump ball tie up there. Whistle for the foul. Sub will come in for Asheville. Number 13, that's Antonio Pierce. And checking out will be Malik Williams.
Will be Asheville basketball underneath their own basket. They look inside. They get it inside, but going to the floor. And that is a traveling call on Antonio Pierce. Turnover Bulldogs. And here come the Bears quickly. Inside, we've got a whistle and a foul, and this will be a two-shot opportunity for Lincoln, as walking to the line will be Dante Rivers for Lincoln.
Landon Cornett will pick up his second foul. 1:45 to go here in the first quarter, as Rivers will hit the first one.
Dante Rivers, just a junior for Coach Rush Rutledge. Second free throw, made them both. The Bears by six. And a near steal by Rivers. Shot in the air by Asheville is no good. Coming out of there with the rebounds, Isaac Davis for the Bears, and Lincoln wants to run. Lincoln always wants to run. Jason?
Certainly does, as Rivers, bad pass there, was able to get in a half court set, trying to rush it there. Need to slow it down and get a good shot, but this second group still able to maintain that six-point lead.
Under 90 seconds to go, and in the backcourt, Lincoln just a bit too aggressive on the defensive's end, and Carmichael picks up his personal.
Well, you see that hand checking there coming to play, the quick whistle there as soon as Carmichael put the hands on there.
D'Angelo Williams in the near turnover, and it is a turnover. Again, the pressure defense of Lincoln's paying big dividends here in the opening quarter. Multiple turnovers by Asheville created by that Bear defense.
Carter and Williams got tied up there and trying to decide who would get it. Carter traveled with it.
They look inside. Now they go inside out. Ellis three. Yes, can write it down. Isaac Davis from downtown.
Second three for Lincoln in this first quarter.
Is Asheville again in a trap, and there is a steal by Rivers. Rivers the other way quickly. A pull up just inside, three-point land off the back of the rim, no good. And there's Asheville with the rebound. Coming away with it's Antonio Pierce. Half minute to go. Asheville shot blocked. Swatting that one away was L.J. Carmichael. It will remain Asheville basketball.
L.J. sends that one whizzing by the head of one of our FNN cameramen over there.
Asheville, and the ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by Lincoln. Still Bulldog basketball.
30 seconds to go in the first quarter. Lincoln in control of this one.
Three-pointer is up and short, put up by Cater. Second shot opportunity is no good. There's Carmichael with the rebound for the Bears. And here comes Lincoln. This is Davis. Davis with Rivers. Right back to Davis. Davis drives baseline. His little floater is in the air. No good. Tipped up. Tipped in. That's Savion Woods, and the Bears move on top by double digits. Now up by 11. Cater's three at the buzzer is no good. And that is the end of the first quarter. And after 8 minutes of action, you see Lincoln on top of Asheville by 11. You're watching the Friday Night Network.
Imagine, this is your money, and someone wants to take it from you. Who is it? The IRS. Guess what? They want your money, and they can take it, all of it if they want. Remember, they sent you that letter right over here that said, hey, you owe us a bunch of cash, and we're gonna take it from you right now. So what do? You fight back by letting our team of experts work it out with the IRS so you can keep your money. And hey, we're good at what we do. When you hire us, you get a team of guys on your side that know the IRS laws, and we'll fight really hard to save your money. So, if you owe the IRS a ton of cash and you want to keep it, call right now and learn for free how we can help you put it back in your pocket. 5 minutes of your time right now can save you thousands of dollars. And the best part, it's a free call. So please call right now.
All right, here we go. Second quarter action. Jeff Ellison alongside Jason Palman. The Friday Night Network's coverage of the Lincoln Thanksgiving Invitational. It's day number one, the fourth game of the opening session. It's Asheville basketball as we get underway here in period number two.
Seven players for Lincoln in the scoring column in that first quarter. Six of those seven are seniors. So, we talked about the depth of Lincoln, and it really showed in that first quarter as he let the second group play pretty much about three and a half minutes in that second quarter, Jeff, and they didn't miss a beat. Not as fluent as that first group, but they didn't relinquish the lead, was able to get some good shots. But seven players scoring in that first quarter, that's pretty deep.
Yes, it is. Quite impressive. You see Hunter Huckabee at the line for Asheville. Missed the first. He'll have one more.
Raquel Truss checks into the game, the 5'7 junior for Lincoln.
Huckabee goes one of two at the stripe. The lead is 10. Golden Bears in their half court set. This is Hempel, and they'll back it out near the timeline. Again, Asheville not coming out, so Bears just taking their time here. Now there's a wide open three, knocking it down. Hempel from deep.
You leave him open, he'll knock it down. 5 points for Hempel.
The lead's 13. Out of bounds, it will be Asheville basketball. Heads up over there, partner.
Yeah, I tell you, I was looking down at my scoring sheet. Hempel had 23 points when they beat B.B. Comer earlier, and he can really light it up.
Asheville basketball in the front court. Lincoln and a man-to-man. Huckabee, and there's a steal by the Bears. Shot up. Count it and send him to the line.
Close to being a flagrant foul there, Jeff. Real close, as there's a hard foul, as Whiteside evidently was going to go to the basket hard, possibly slamming that thing down. You got to be careful there, as Cornut is, that was a dangerous play. Dangerous play.
Whiteside to convert the three-point play, and he does.
Cornut, if I'm not mistaken, my sheet's right. That's his third foul.
Yeah. Asheville trying to break this full court pressure of the Bears, and they do as they get it into the front court. This is Cornut. He's picked up his dribble now, and the ball is knocked out of bounds by Lincoln. It will remain Asheville basketball as Zay Caldwell was there to deflect that pass.
Caldwell picks up the foul. It's Lincoln's sixth foul. Cornut will have to take a seat, picking up his third foul. And checking in for him will be number 24. That's Malik Williams.
Noah Cater, the senior. For Coach Seth Ford and the Asheville Bulldogs. This is Williams. Now outside three-pointer is put up off the mark by Judd Monday. One shot, and that's all for Asheville, and the Bears right back down the floor. Looking inside, now they go to Hemphill back out, and Hemphill says, slow down, guys, and let's set the offense.
Hemphill looks like he's got something in his eye there, trying to slow it down to get it out, but Malik Weed taking it inside, misses the shot.
Spin move is no good. Whiteside had the rebound momentarily, loses possession of it, and here comes Asheville the other way. This is Noah Cater. Cater's pass is intercepted, stolen away by Whiteside, all the way and laying it in for the easy two. Inside, Malik Williams misses the layup. Out of bounds it goes, and will go the other way as Asheville commits the foul. Lincoln basketball, 5:38 still to go here in the opening half. Lincoln already, you see the score, they lead by 18.
Rivers will check in. Well, it's 21 for the Golden Bears. Chris Prince. Pretty much, like you said, all 14 players, I think, have been in the game at some point.
Yeah, that's right.
And we're 5:25 to go in the first half.
There's a three-pointer that is well off the mark. No good. That was Prince that tried one from long range, and now Asheville beats Lincoln down the floor and gets the easy two on the home run pass.
D'Angelo Williams knocks that one down.
16-point Bear lead. Easy two on the other end for the Bears. It's Montrell Johnson with his first bucket. Again, another pass down the floor, retrieved and now stolen away by Lincoln. Here comes D. Whiteside.
Bodies flying all over the floor. Three bodies on the floor.
Second down and four at the 19-yard line. This foul will be on Asheville. It's a non-shooting foul. Bear basketball. They'll trigger it in underneath their own basket. This is Dante Rivers to throw it in. Driving baseline, double team, putting up a shot that's partially blocked. That's Truss, and coming out of there with it, the Bulldogs. Noah Cater quickly down the floor. Shot up, no, but a whistle and a foul, and Asheville will be shooting free throws.
A lot of sloppy play on both ends of the floor. You know, trying to run, not getting in the half court set, and you're seeing a lot of ugly shots and a lot of ugly fouls going on.
Yeah, Jason Lincoln just wants to get you out of your comfort zone, wants you to play just 78 RPM.
D'Angelo Williams will hit the free throw.
And he'll have one more. Take every dead ball, it seems like we have a substitution. Williams makes them both. The lead is 16, just 4.5 minutes still to play in the second quarter. Near steal, tie up on the floor, possession arrow, we will stay. On that end of the floor, it will remain Bear basketball.
Rivers a little careless with the ball that time. Cater playing good defense. Was able to tie that one up.
Lincoln. Three-pointer is up. Off the back of the rim, no good.
Headed your way.
Had to save the monitor there. It goes out of bounds. That's what Jim would want.
Yeah, Jim appreciates that.
Yeah.
Quick hands. You still got it.
Have a meeting. Media timeout. 4 minutes to go here in the opening half. It's all Golden Bears on the Friday Night Network.
Have you got the new car itch but don't want to take the plunge with a brand new car? How about getting the most car for the money at Avery Auto Sales? They have a large selection of cars with even some 2014s in the mix. And if you're worried about your credit, don't. They can help get you back on your credit feet with guaranteed approval. Check them out online at AveryAutoSales.net. Then when you see something you like, call them at 256-835-8897 for a test drive. Or just go by. Avery Auto Sales is located on Highway 78 East between Highway 78 and Snow Street in Oxford. That's Avery Auto Sales.
Since 1848, our bank has witnessed inventions that have changed the world. Conveniences such as the refrigerator, the light bulb, and the airplane were all created during the early days of our bank. VHS tapes, DVDs, smartphones, all invented while we were First National Bank of Talladega. Our name may have changed, but we have a rich history. First Bank of Alabama, we're still first, and so are you.
The Lincoln Thanksgiving Invitational. The Golden Bears of Lincoln and the Bulldogs of Ashville. I'm over in St. Clair County. 4 minutes to go here in the opening half. Lincoln on top by 16 with the basketball. Everybody that has dressed out tonight has played for Coach Russ Rutledge. And now there's a three-pointer put up by Truss. It's no good. Another shot on the second shot opportunity. This one by Rivers. It's no good. However, he is fouled. And Rivers will walk to the line and shoot a pair.
Reagan Wilson will pick up the foul. That'll be the 17th foul on Asheville. So being a bonus, as Rivers will miss the first.
One more for Rivers.
Pierce and Doreen Williams will check back in for Asheville.
One more for Rivers. And got the kind roll that time. The lead 17. Near turnover. It is a turnover. Rivers with the loose ball. And here comes Lincoln once more. Three-pointer is in the air, put up by Johnson. It's no good. Whiteside goes up strong. I tell you, Whiteside's a force inside, Jason, and just multiple offensive rebounds, and he will be rewarded as he goes to the line to shoot two.
10 points in the ballgame for Whiteside. Like you said, he is strong in the post, in the paint. You hate to look ahead, but the matchup between him and Doss, that'd be one of the better matchups of the tournament if Lincoln goes on and wins this game. White Plains, the winner of our previous game, 75-59 over Sylacauga.
One more free throw for Whiteside. First name is D. D-E-E. And that's two misses from the stripe. But last touch by Asheville as the ball sails out of bounds. Lincoln will have another opportunity here on the offensive end.
Savion Woods will check back in. He'll check in for Whiteside. Cornut, surprised to see him checking in. Yeah. 3:23 to go in the first half. He's got three fouls. Kind of played a little reckless there in the ball game so far. Just a sophomore.
Zay Caldwell to Hemp Hill. Around the horn they go, and this is Davis firing up a three that's no good. And Asheville ahead of everyone, and we're going to wave it off.
Cornut hit the layup. Ball was going in, and Pierce grabbed the rim.
That's offensive basket interference. Takes two off the board, and the score will stay at 35-18. Caldwell to Davis. This is Hempfield for three. Nothing but nylon from the corner.
Got a smooth stroke from the hardest spot on the floor to hit it.
Asheville breaks the press. Now on a drive, putting up a shot. Good looking shot, too. The easy two by Hunter Huckabee of the Bulldogs.
His first basket of the game.
Lincoln near turnover. He gets it back. Shot up. It's no good. One shot, and that is all. Putting that one up was Savion Woods. And here comes Asheville the other way. Pierce. Kick out. Three-pointer. Up. Good. Cornut from downtown.
Good job by Pierce catching the ball and then finding Cornett open under outside for the three-point basket. Now a jump ball underneath. It will be Ashville's basketball.
Yeah, held ball and the possession arrow to Ashville. Down by 15 now with 2:10 to go. Noah Cater. Hemphill with a steal. Missed the layup, but the follow is there by Caldwell. Ashville gets it into the front court. Cater's double team. Now he splits the defenders. And he leaves it with Zarian Williams, and Williams hands it off to Cornut. Cornut right back to Cater, and here we go with the Ashville half court set. Lincoln in a man to man, a minute and a half to go in the first half from Golden Bear Land. This is Huckabee. Huckabee drives inside, now kicks it out for the three by Cornut. That's an air ball, and Hemphill comes out of there with it. Pass ahead, shot up, no. That's Zay Caldwell. Lincoln has no trouble at all getting it up the floor in a hurry, do they?
No, they don't. And I think that foul is going to be on Cornut. And if so, that's his fourth with a minute 16 to go in the first half.
Caldwell's free throw is in and out. He'll have one more as Lincoln will bring in, well, four new substitutions.
Ashville only with nine players on the roster, and Cornut now with four fouls. Don't agree with the decision to bring him back in there. You're going to need him in that second half, and only got one more foul to go there. He did hit a three-pointer for Ashville, but
this is Cater. Noah Cater for Coach Seth Ford's Bulldogs. Cater's a senior. Goes right side to Huckabee, a junior. Left wing, three-pointer is up and in and out by Judd Monday. And here comes Lincoln the other way.
Lincoln pushing the ball up the floor off of every miss.
Final minutes of the second quarter. An impressive first half for Lincoln in their opening round game of the tournament. There's a three-pointer that's up and no good. That one fired up by C.J. Orr, rebounded by Asheville. Cater from three-point land, off the back of the rim, no good. A whistle and a foul will go the other way. Asheville has committed the foul on the rebound, and Lincoln will walk to the other line and shoot free throws.
Antonio Pierce on the foul. That's his first foul. A two-shot foul now. It's double bonus time.
And that's Trey Ellis that will shoot these two free throws. 18-point lead for the Bears. Lincoln 2-0 on the year with wins over B.B. Comer and the Weaver Bearcats. Asheville 1-2. Their lone win was a 2-point victory over Raglan, the Purple Devils, and they've lost to Moody and lost in the last second to the Pell City Panthers. Second free throw is no good. Rebounded by Ashville. Huckabee inside to go to Williams. His shot is up. No, but he is fouled inside in the act. And two free throws now for Williams as he'll go to the line, the sophomore.
Christian Prince on the foul.
41-23.
The winner of this game will face the White Plains Wildcats tomorrow night in the nightcap at 8:30.
Yes, we'll have that game for you right here on the Friday Night Network. Brady and Jason with the call. Speaking of White Plains, they're headed to the bus right now. Second free throw is up and good. 10 seconds to go. Inside, shot up and good. That's Malik Weed for the Golden Bears, and the lead goes back to 19. Still by the Bears. Shot up, shot good by Chris Prince as the horn sounds. four quick ones in the last 5 seconds of the quarter, and the Golden Bears will go to the locker room with their biggest lead of the game, 45-24. We'll step aside. We'll take a break. We'll be back with halftime from Golden Bear Gymnasium. You're watching the Friday Night Network.
People come from everywhere to get their deal from Bill Stanford.
They come from Ashland, Brompton, Lineville. They come from Moody, Munford, Coldwater, Birmingham, Talladega, Lincoln, Riverside, Heflin. There's no better deal than a Talladega Bill deal.
Right now, all Ram trucks are at or below supplier price. Save over $2,700 on this 2015 Ram 1500 at Bill Stanford.
Come on out to Bill Stanford
in Talladega.
In a world that's ever-changing, you have to be sure that your choices are the right choices. At Central Alabama Community College, you'll know you made the best choice. We understand that you need the best educational opportunities. Whether choosing a technical degree program, taking courses to transfer to a four-year college or university, or being a part of our national championship-winning traditions, Central Alabama will provide you with courses and degree programs in tune with today's workplace. Get a sharper focus on your life by choosing one of our three convenient locations, Alex City, Childersburg, and Talladega. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
Is your business growing and now you need a new and bigger building? Has your organization outgrown their facility and now it's time to expand? Do your hobbies require the need for more space? If you're paying rent, but now you want the advantages of owning, the prospect of financing, construction, and on-time completion may seem out of your reach. General Steel Corporation has the answer. A pre-engineered steel building from the General will not only look great and satisfy almost any need, but you'll save time and money. Our team will help you create your building and deliver it to your location. We offer design services to help you present your concept to board members, bankers, or for fundraising. And the General can even help with financing. General Steel is a name you know, with quality backed by a 50-year structural warranty. Call today and find out how easy it is to have the building you want. You may even save up to $20,000 with rebates. If you need space, you need the General.
Step into the offices of J. Britt Middlebrook, CPA, where you'll find professional one-on-one service for business and individual clients. In this ever-changing tax and economic climate, you can count on receiving the expert advice you need. J. Britt Middlebrook works hard to provide every client what they need to meet all deadlines. Tax season will be here soon. For all your accounting service needs, call or stop by at 1913 Berry Street in Oxford. That's J. Britt Middlebrook, CPA. Every day is a great day to stop in a Samco Express Mart. You'll find plenty of snacks to choose from, and Samco has all your favorite drink brands, all nice and cold. You'll find those last-minute light grocery items you need, and a great variety of grab-and-go brands that's sure to cure any case of the munchies. There's lots of candy, mints, and gum, too. Make sure you fuel up before or after the game. With over 30 locations in the area, there's always one close by. Samco Express Mart.
Professional Apothecary has been the Talladega area's trusted hometown pharmacy for generations. We can meet all your prescription and insurance needs. Plus, you'll find all the basic over-the-counter medications. There's a full line of support hose, and don't forget to check out our Dollar Saver Shelf. When it comes to medical supplies, Professional Apothecary has you covered. You'll find everything from mobility needs to home and portable oxygen, CPAP equipment and supplies, easy lift chairs, and a full line of Dr. Comfort shoes.
Merry Christmas from Professional Apothecary.
Just off the square in Talladega.
Since 1848, our bank has witnessed inventions that have changed the world. Conveniences such as the refrigerator, the light bulb, and the airplane were all created during the early days of our bank. VHS tapes, DVDs, smartphones, all invented while we were First National Bank of Talladega. Our name may have changed, but we have a rich history. First Bank of Alabama. We're still first, and so are you.
All right, welcome to back to the Lincoln Thanksgiving Tournament. We are at the halftime. Lincoln on top of Asheville, 45-24. Earlier games tonight, Winterboro
loses to Pell City on last second shot, 42-41. Westbrook Christian defeating 69, Moody 62. And then White Plains Wildcats defeating the Sylacauga Aggies 75-59. And now joining me is Westbrook Christian's coach, Coach Donnie Pruitt. Coach, congratulations on the win. Your team improves to 3-0 on the season. Talk about that win against Moody.
Well, it was a real difficult win. They seemed like every time we'd get a lead with, 8, 10, 12 points, they would come back, and they made a lot of big shots, made a lot of big plays. You know, I think we were up about 12 with just under 2 minutes to go in the game, and, you have to tip your hat to them because they just kept battling back. And really, of course, I was proud of our kids to come back after we'd given up the leads like that and be able to pull it out in the end, and all. But they I thought Moody played extremely well. I'd seen them play earlier this year, and they shot the ball a whole lot better than I did that I saw them that night. They played well.
Three good games already here in this tournament. Seems like the matchups have been fairly even
right
here in the tournament. That matchup with Moody there, like you said, they really shot the ball well in that fourth quarter, pulled it close. Playing Pell City, a 6A team,
right,
tomorrow night at the 7 o'clock game, I believe that is.
Right.
Pell City winning on a last-second shot, 42-41. They've got two guys on that team that's been playing for Coach Grant there since the ninth grade, that started ever since the ninth grade. Luke Daniels can really fill it up. Averaged 28 points coming into the game tonight.
Wow.
Had 17 tonight. Can really shoot the ball well. He's a matchup nightmare because he'll post up down low and then shoot it from the outside. So they really like to get him the ball there. Were you able to see that game? Were you defending
Pell
City?
It was one of those games they played before us, so we weren't sure which team we would be playing, depending on whether
right
we won or lost. So,
yeah,
we just had to watch a little bit of both of them. And like you said, it was just back and forth, and we really didn't know, to be honest with you. Really, for us, this tournament, we're small 3A. And, I mean, we missed being 2A by 0.6 students.
Yeah.
Less than one student. And for us, I think we're the second smallest school here. Winterboro is smaller than us. So it's a good opportunity for us to be able to play against really good competition, 5A, Moody, and then, like you say, 6A, Pell City. And, this is just really good for us to try to toughen us up as we go into our area competition.
Talk about your team real quick and the makeup of your team, your seniors.
Yeah, we've got a good many seniors coming back this year. We have six seniors on our team. We've had kind of a no-injury bug. We had several kids move this past year, and that kind of hurts a little bit. But we've got right now my backup point guard. He pulled a hip flexor last Thursday, and he hasn't played at all this tournament, probably won't play. Had another kid who started for us at center last year who has had back problems, and he hasn't been able to play. So we've been having to try to put some other people out there. But the good thing is these other guys are getting an opportunity to play. So hopefully, it'll help us in the long run.
I made a comment about your team earlier tonight during one of our games that your team plays like my team played when I was in high school. I went to a private school,
right,
and it seemed like we always wanted to play with a chip on our shoulder,
right,
to prove something to everybody.
Right.
I noticed that out of your team, a lot of feistiness, a lot of hustle,
right,
a lot of aggressiveness, and it's fun to watch your team play. Very fundamentally sound, get after the ball on defense, and unselfish on offense.
Well, I don't know how fundamentally sound we were tonight, because I know we usually, whenever they made runs on us, is when we turned the ball over. I know in the third quarter there, we turned it over like six trips. We turned it over five times, and we normally don't turn the ball over like that.
Yeah.
And we did the same thing down the stretch, in the fourth quarter. And, of course, we turned over and then knock a three down on us. They made us pay, too. So.
That was Coach Donnie Pruitt for Westbrook Christian. We'll have them tomorrow night here on the FNN Network. We invite you to stay tuned. Go to www.fnnnetwork.com. You also can pull up the app and pull it up, get the free app there to watch the games. Thanks, Coach Pruitt.
Thank
good
you
luck to you tomorrow night.
Thank you. Appreciate
we'll
it.
Take a quick break. When we come back, we'll have second half action for you here on FNN, the Friday Night Network.
Now Need a place to keep your tools?
Or a place to get away from the wife? Whatever your needs are, we got a barn or a carport for you.
With rent-to-own options and no credit checks, we can help you take home the right barn or carport today.
And with four different locations, we're just a short drive away.
So come see us in Glencove, Moody, Asheville, or Atala, and let our family help your family get the barn or carport you deserve.
People come from everywhere to get their deal from Bill Stanford.
They come from Ashland, Brompton, Lineville. They come from Moody, Munford, Coldwater, Birmingham, Talladega, Lincoln, Riverside, Heflin. There's no better deal than a Talladega Bill deal.
Right now, all GMC Sierras are at or below supplier price. Save over $2,900 on this 2015 GMC Sierra at Bill Stanford.
Come on out to Bill Stanford
in Talladega.
Those kids got a kick out of it, didn't
they? Yeah. 45-24 the score, you see. We're ready to play basketball once more as the Bears will have possession of the basketball to get this third period underway. Tough hill to climb for the Bulldogs, as you see, starting the quarter down by 21.
Nine players for Lincoln scoring in that first half. Well-rounded team. Starters back on the floor now.
And we've seen, been down that road before as Hemphill knocks another big three down from deep.
Three threes in the first, or in the ball game for Hemphill.
The Bears have doubled up Ashville here as they lead by 24.
Cornut into the game now with those four.
Here comes
fouls.
Two more easy ones for the Bears. Created off the defense, Malik Weed with the easy two. Credit the assist to Zay Caldwell. We got a whistle and a foul, a little bit too aggressive that time defensively. They'll whistle Malik Weed with the personal.
Malik Weed, a late addition to the roster. Coach Rutledge coming over and putting his name down before the ball game. And he is a aggressive type player on defense, very fast. Only about 5'6". Handles the ball well.
Shot up this time and up and no good. Landon Cornut with the shot attempt. However, he is fouled driving baseline. Cornut will shoot two.
Carmichael with the foul. That's Lincoln's second foul.
Rush Rutledge, head coach. Of course, he's coaching at his alma mater here. He attended high school here at Lincoln. His dad, Ricky, former coach here at Lincoln, won a state championship 35 years ago as head basketball coach.
You know, talking to Rush before the game and said it's been 30 years since they've been to a regional tournament.
Yeah.
That's one of their goals.
Yeah, that may change this year. That's an easy two for Quinn Carmichael. And again, give the dime to Malik Weed. Almost another turnover. The Bears up by 28 in this one. Jason, I have a question. I know you're a former official, and I'm sure you can answer this. It's a tournament game. Is the 30-point rule in effect in the fourth quarter?
Yes.
It is. Okay. Good.
Any regular season game, it will be that way. When you get into the playoffs, that rule isn't in effect.
28-point lead now, and Ashville wants and gets a timeout. This will be a 30. We'll take a break with them on the Friday Night Network.
Every day's a great day to stop in a Samco Express Mart. You'll find plenty of snacks to choose from, and Samco has all your favorite drink brands, all nice and cold. You'll find those last-minute light grocery items you need, and a great variety of grab-and-go brands that's sure to cure any case of the munchies. There's lots of candy, mints, and gum, too. Make sure you fuel up. Before or after the game, with over 30 locations in the area, there's always one close by. Samco Express Mart.
Ashville basketball as the inbound side front court. They get it into Hunter Huckabee. Again, the Bears remain in their man-to-man. Noah Cater out high. Cater looks to drive, does drive, and lays it in. Just was able to beat his man defensively. Malik Weed off the dribble and get the easy two.
Cater's first bucket of the game comes with 6:08 to go here in the third quarter.
That's Caldwell from three-point land, and you can write it down. The Bears on top by 29.
Two threes for Caldwell in the game.
Cater off the glass, no good. Hemphill with the outlet pass to Whiteside for two more.
This Lincoln team, very well conditioned, runs the floor so good.
Well, they get the defensive rebound. The first thing they do is look down the floor. I mean, they're ready to go. It's not like a lot of teams, they look for the point guard to bring it down the floor.
Yeah.
I mean, they're looking all the way to the other end of the floor. They want the home run pass.
Yeah, and, you know, all five guys that are on the floor for Lincoln can handle the ball, much like White Plains. Mm-hmm. That's why that matchup tomorrow night is going to be a very interesting one because, you know, White Plains the same way. Everybody can put the ball on the floor and push it up the floor. It'll be interesting to see how that matchup will pan out.
Truss loses possession of it. There's a fight for it on the floor. And finally, we got a whistle and a held ball, and the possession arrow will go to the team wearing green. That's Asheville. 5:17, still to go, third quarter. Friday Night Network's coverage of the Lincoln Thanksgiving Invitational. Opening round action will be here tomorrow night. We'll be here Wednesday as well for the championship. Cater is fouled in the backcourt. That's Truss with the personal. And Asheville will inbound the basketball near midcourt.
It's a fourth team foul on Lincoln.
And this is Cater to bring it up the floor. Cater guarded by Truss and the man-to-man. That's Monday. Monday throws it away. Turnover Asheville. Truss in the front court for Lincoln. Lincoln 2-0 on the year, and there's a layup. An easy one for L.J. Carmichael.
L.J.'s first basket in the game. Good look inside for the Golden Bears.
Cater with the floater inside. Two more for Asheville, and Whiteside ahead of everyone down the floor, but he is fouled, and this will be a non-shooting foul. Prior to being in the act of shooting, Asheville's foul, and Lincoln will inbound the basketball. Tomorrow night, in all likelihood, and it will be Lincoln if this score holds, and gotta like the Bears' chances in this one tonight, don't you?
Oh, most certainly.
Up by 31, and Jason talked about earlier, the Bears will play White Plains tomorrow night. That'll be a battle of two undefeated teams early on here in the 2015-16 season.
Montrell Johnson checks in for Caldwell. Subs continue to flow in. So like you said earlier in the game, every dead ball, there's a substitution coming in for Lincoln. 14 players on the bench, and every one of them play. And it's not like they're getting mop-up duty time either. They're contributing when they come in. There's a loose ball on the floor, jump ball, it'll go. It'll be Lincoln's ball. There's another substitution come in, and now 4:06 to go. We've got a media timeout.
So we'll step aside as well. Again, it's all Golden Bears leading by 31 on the Friday Night Network.
Have you got the new car itch but don't want to take the plunge with a brand new car? How about getting the most car for the money at Avery Auto Sales? They have a large selection of cars with even some 2014s in the mix. And if you're worried about your credit, don't. They can help get you back on your credit feet with guaranteed approval. Check them out online at AveryAutoSales.net. Then when you see something you like, call them at 256-835-8897 for a test drive. Or just go by. Avery Auto Sales is located on Highway 78 East between Highway 78 and Snow Street in Oxford. That's Avery Auto Sales.
Oops, had a fender bender? Have them tow it or take it yourself to Wesley's Paint and Body. Baker Reynolds and his guys have been this area's go-to team for quality automotive body repair and paint work for years. All makes and models, foreign or domestic, they take them crashed and make them look like new. And with Wesley's larger new facility, including two full-size paint booths, they can get you fixed up fast. Always free estimates, best price on repair work, insurance claims welcomed, and service with a smile. That's Wesley's Paint and Body, Highway 78 East in Anniston.
4:06, period number three. Lincoln by 31. Will be Bear basketball as we do resume play. You ready for Thursday, Jason?
Oh, most certainly. Most certainly. You're invited too, by the way, since you've already had your Thanksgiving.
Yeah, my family has ours 3 weeks early.
Wow.
We're kind of in the minority on that, I'm sure. And there's a turnover by Lincoln. Shot up and in on the other end. Hunter Huckabee for the easy two. Bears back down the floor. That's an air ball by Carmichael, rebounded by Asheville. The lead's 29. Noah Caters run the point for Coach Seth Ford and the Asheville Bulldogs in this game to get it inside to the big guy Williams. His shot's no good. He gets the loose ball, goes back up again, and on the second try, he's fouled, and he'll go to the line and shoot a pair.
Christian Prince fouling from behind. It's his second foul, the team's fifth. It's a 29-point lead by Lincoln. And they're pretty much everything that we thought they would be coming in. Like you heard a lot about this team, eight seniors on the ball club, by far the most experienced team in this area. Three leading scores returning as well coming into this season. Whiteside, Hill, and Caldwell all back. And so a lot of expectations on this Lincoln team. And right now they're looking the part. And barring injury, you know, you got to think, Jeff, that they're going to be in a run for at least an area tournament champion or a runner-up to try to get to JSU.
Yeah, and you know, Jason, they play in a pretty doggone good area, too. Class 5A Area 12 with St. Clair County, Anniston, and Alexandria.
Alexandria's
not even started basketball yet. So, yeah, it is tough. And, of course, Coach Rutledge knows that. Will be Lincoln basketball with 2:47 to go.
You know, they haven't won the area since 2001, and it's been, like I said earlier, been 30 years since they've been past the sub-region, as here's a steal and a layup
by Huckabee. Two more for the Bulldogs. The lead's 25.
You're talking about the area for Lincoln. Their first area game will be December 15th at St. Clair County.
Yeah, four-team area. Well, Asheville, too. You know, area 11 out of class 3A for the Bulldogs with Glencoe and Ohatchee and Westbrook Christian. Free throws, two of them for Lincoln. One more.
Caldwell, Woods, checking back in for Lincoln.
Isaac Davis. Not many guys like to wear number zero. Isaac has no problem with it. Davis, a senior. Made one of two. Near the two-minute mark of the third quarter. It's a
is Monday inside the Williams, the wide body with two more.
Williams, the leading scorer for this Asheville team with 12 points.
Johnson turns it over. Cater gets away, comes out of there with it. Gets the loose ball, and Cater the other way. They got a two-on-one, and they'll bring it back out. And almost a turnover, but Asheville will have the basketball underneath their own basket. Had a two-on-one, really a three-on-one there, but the spacing was a little bit of the problem on that fast break for Asheville. There's a three-pointer. Yes, sir. That is D'Angelo Williams. Three-ball corner pocket. And the Bears lead now by just 21.
Asheville's third three-pointer of the game.
Inside, shot up is short. Fight for it inside and scramble for it. And we got a whistle, and the officials will sort this one out. And we'll go the other way. It will be Asheville basketball. We have a timeout, as a matter of fact, taken by Asheville as prior to the tie-up. So it's a full timeout, and we'll be back in 60 seconds on the Friday Night Network.
Since 1848, our bank has witnessed inventions that have changed the world. Conveniences such as the refrigerator, the light bulb, and the airplane were all created during the early days of our bank. VHS tapes, DVDs, smartphones, all invented while we were First National Bank of Talladega. Our name may have changed, but we have a rich history. First Bank of Alabama, we're still first, and so are you.
People come from everywhere to get their deal from Bill Stanford.
They come from Ashland, Brompton, Lineville. They come from Moody, Munford, Coldwater, Birmingham, Talladega, Lincoln, Riverside, Heflin. There's no better deal than a Talladega Bill deal.
Right now, all GMC Sierras are at or below supplier price. Save over $2,900 on this 2015 GMC Sierra at Bill Stanford.
Come on out to Bill Stanford
in Talladega.
All right, here we go. 1:17 still to play in the third quarter. Friday Night Network, Jeff Ellison, Jason Pommen from Lincoln High School. 21-point lead for the Bears. Cater drives inside, draws contact, and he'll go to the line one more time.
Fouled hard that time underneath. 42 got him for the Golden Bears. That's Montrell Johnson.
Noah Cater, see him there, he's a senior. He'll shoot two, the lead's 20.
Cornett will check back into the game, he's got four fouls. Also, will check back in for the Golden Bears, Malik Weed.
Asheville on a little bit of a run here. They trailed at one point by 31, now down by just 20. The chance to get it inside 20. And they do. The lead's 19. Down the floor of the Bears. With Malik Weed goes left side to Davis. Davis right back to Weed. Weed thought about it. Now he goes right wing to Johnson. Inside they go. From the block, putting up a little five-foot baseline jump shot, knocking it down is L.J. Carmichael for the Bears. Back to 21. Cater guarded by Weed, the Bears in the man-to-man. Picks up his dribble, now he goes left wing to Reagan Wilson. Inside to go to Williams, his shot is up no good. Got his own rebound, goes up a second time. Still not there, third shot up, yes. That's D'Angelo Williams, 62-43, with 10 seconds to go in the quarter.
D'Angelo with 9 points.
Shot inside, no. Carmichael with the follow, no. Second time by Carmichael, it's up and no good. Williams with a rebound for Asheville. horn sounds, and that is the end of the third quarter. And after 24 minutes of play, Ashville trailing by 19 to the Golden Bears, we are the Friday Night Network.
Tom Young and all the attorneys of Young, Wolstein, Jackson, and Whittington are some of the most experienced and respected attorneys in the area. Their firm specializes in personal injury, insurance fraud, workers' compensation, social security disability, real estate, and corporate law. The law firm of Young, Wolstein, Jackson, and Whittington. Call them at 256-235-2240.
No representation is made that the quality of the legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other lawyers.
In a world that's ever-changing, you have to be sure that your choices are the right choices. At Central Alabama Community College, you'll know you made the best choice. We understand that you need the best educational opportunities. Whether choosing a technical degree program, taking courses to transfer to a four-year college or university, or being a part of our national championship-winning traditions, Central Alabama will provide you with courses and degree programs in tune with today's workplace. Get a sharper focus on your life by choosing one of our three convenient locations, Alex City, Childersburg, and Talladega. Central Alabama Community College, central to you, central to your success.
Here we go, fourth quarter. Ashville possession down by 19 to begin this final 8 minutes.
Both teams with all five starters on the floor. Here's Cater for a three, another one.
And suddenly the lead's down to 16. What was once a 31-point Bear advantage, almost cut in half. 62-46 now. Ashville remains in their zone. Hempfield out high, out between the circles. And they go left side to Caldwell. Hempfield, they swing it around the horn to Ellis. Hempfield, Caldwell. Caldwell drives baseline, picks up his dribble and turns it over. Ashville the other way, shot up, it's no good. Hempfield may have deflected that one. And the Bears turn it right back over to Ashville. Coming out of there with it is D'Angelo Williams, who leaves it with Cater. There's a three-pointer by Cornett. It's no good. It's slapped out toward midcourt. Caldwell comes away with it for Lincoln, leaves it with Whiteside. His shot is up and no good. It's getting a little wild here. Back and forth we go. Inside pass intended for Pierce. Sails out of bounds. Will be Golden Bear basketball. I don't think Rush Rutledge is happy right now. I can see him across the way, Jason.
A lot of turnovers.
Bears aren't playing like he wants them to.
A lot of turnovers. They let Ashville somewhat get back into this ball game after, like you said, having a 31-point lead at one point in the ball game.
This is Hempfield. Around the horn they go. Ellis. Ellis looks inside. Nothing there. Back to Caldwell.
Lincoln content right now with running some clock out, looking for the open man.
Ellis puts up a shot that's no good. And there's Cornett with the rebound for Ashville, and he nearly turns it over. And he does turn it over. Lincoln basketball. Now we have a timeout taken by Ashville, and this will be a 30-second timeout, and we'll be back in 30 on the Friday Night Network.
Every day is a great day to stop in a Samco Express Mart. You'll find plenty of snacks to choose from, and Samco has all your favorite drink brands, all nice and cold. You'll find those last-minute light grocery items you need, and a great variety of grab-and-go brands that's sure to cure any case of the munchies. There's lots of candy, mints, and gum, too. Make sure you fuel up. Before or after the game, with over 30 locations in the area, there's always one close by. Samco Express Mart.
6:05 to go in the basketball game from Lincoln. The host team of the tournament up by 16. It will be Bear basketball as Hempfield will throw it in, and he does to Ellis. Ellis back out high, and this is Zay Caldwell. Zay was a quarterback on the team, on the football team.
Yes, he was.
I remember that. Cross court pass to Hemphill. Now they try a little high-low action inside to get it in to Whiteside, and he is fouled, and Whiteside will walk to the free throw line and shoot two.
The loser of this game will face Sylacauga in the second round tomorrow at 4 o'clock. And whoever that may be, that's a tough second-round matchup.
Yeah, it is.
Sylacauga, you know, very talented team. You know, White Plains jumped out on early 19-11 in that first quarter and got Sylacauga out of their game, so to speak. Got them in foul trouble where they had to back off that press. But Sylacauga, very talented team. They have a lot of wins this year.
Yeah, this Will Copeland, his third year there, heading up the Aggie program. A lot of high expectations down in Aggie land this year. Again, they'll be playing tomorrow against the loser of this contest. Looped it inside to Williams. Just throwing it over the top. And the lead's 15. Hemphill the other way. And he is foul, blocking foul on Asheville. And Tyler Hemphill averaging 24 per game coming into tonight's contest. The senior will walk to the free throw line.
He's had a quiet night, so to speak, so far. 11 points, has hit 3 three-pointers. I believe it's his first time going to the free throw line. 5:25 to go in the fourth quarter.
15-point lead, 16-point lead. One more.
Malik Weed will check in for Terrace Ellis.
64-48. 65-48. The Bears backing out of their full court pressure. They're just playing half court man to man. Hader bounce pass. And the floater from the baseline by Hunter Huckabee. Back to 15. Caldwell thought about it, swings it back out high. This is Weed inside. Weed shot's no good, but the follow is true by Quinn Carmichael. And it goes back to 17.
Carmichael getting good position there underneath. He's able to put the put back up. 8 points in the game for Carmichael.
Cater almost had it stripped away from him. It was last touch by Lincoln. Asheville will maintain possession of the basketball as we near the 4 minute mark in this one. There's a three-pointer up and bottom from deep. That's Zarian Williams, the leading scorer for Asheville. He's had a rather quiet evening.
Scored 5 in that first quarter. He's got 8 now. First bucket since that first.
Shot up by Carmichael is no good, and coming away with a rebound is Asheville. They down by 14. Three-pointer by Cater is short. It's no good. But put back up and in. Williams back-to-back buckets, and the lead is down to 12. Whiteside shot up. Good. Give it to him and send him to the line as Lincoln just beat Asheville down the floor.
Whiteside's first bucket since early in the third quarter.
And Whiteside, the senior, will shoot one. You see him there, D. Whiteside. Anytime I hear the name D and talk about Lincoln basketball, I think of another D that played here about 35 years ago by the name of D. Edison. Went on to play at Central Florida, I think. Was an all-state player for, well, as a matter of fact, for Coach Ricky Rutledge here for the Bears.
You've got a good memory, Jeff.
I'm just old. That's all it is, Jason. I'm old.
Media timeout.
We have a media timeout with 3:51 to go in the game. Lincoln 70, Asheville 55 on the Friday Night Network.
Serving Calhoun County for over 30 years, Crawford Office Supply offers selection, convenience, and low prices. Choose from a wide variety of office furnishings featured in their huge showroom. with savings of 50 to 70% off scratch and dent items. You'll find it all from pens and paper to janitorial supplies at Crawford Office Supply, including on-site printing, all backed up by unmatched personal service and free delivery to local business. Crawford Office Supply, 301 South Layton Avenue in Anniston. Remember, buy local, it matters.
351 is all that's left in this one, and day one of the 2015 Lincoln Thanksgiving Invitational will be in the books as Lincoln leads 70-55. And, you know, during the break we talked about, Lincoln looked so good in the first half and kind of like their, let's give credit to Ashville, obviously, yeah. But still the Bears just don't look the same as they did in the first half.
Ashville got the momentum there about midway through the third quarter and has kept it here into the fourth quarter. Lincoln just, kind of lackadaisical, trying to get through the game, so to speak, and not doing the things that they did in that first half to get them that big lead.
And there is a steal ahead to Whiteside, up off the glass and good.
Tough shot there by Whiteside as going up, got fouled, had to kind of fade away too and off the glass and in. That's a big basket.
And again, that was created by the defense, the steal by Weed on the other end. And 2 points on the offensive end for the Bears, and this could be a three-point trip.
19 points so far in the game for Whiteside.
Seventeen-point lead. Free throw, still 17, and Lincoln is committed the foul. This foul will be on the Bears, L.J. Carmichael, and will walk to the other end.
Both teams in the bonus now. This will be a one-and-one opportunity for Malik Williams, a six-foot sophomore. He's got 9 points in the game to lead the Ashville Bulldogs.
Front end of the 1-and-1. And he misses it. Carmichael gets the rebound ahead to Hephill. Here come the Bears wanting to run. Now wanting to back it out. Now wanting to run clock. And now they find Carmichael all alone underneath for two.
Good look by Hempel. Like I said, wanted to run some clock off there, but a wide open Carmichael underneath and got it to him.
And Huckabee turns it over for Ashville. It goes right back to the Bears. Just over 3 minutes to go. Slowly walking it into the front court. There you see Zay Caldwell. Caldwell bounced right side to Hempel on the right wing. Now Hempel throws it away as he tried to return the pass to Caldwell, and turnover Bears. Noah Cater, who's run the point for the Bulldogs almost the entire game, has done a good job too. Leaves it with Cornut here on the right wing. Looks inside to Williams, not there. There's a three-pointer up, no good. By Cater, and here's Whiteside ahead of everybody with the high finish.
Strong finish there by Whiteside, and that's what the people here from Lincoln has come to see, as Whiteside hadn't had too many opportunities to do that here tonight.
The lead's back to 21. Huckabee's shot is blocked. Cornett picks up the loose ball. Cornett leaves it with Williams and back out high. This is Cater. Cater gets a high ball screen. Step back. Three is in the air. Not this time. Zay Caldwell with a rebound for the Bears. Picks up his dribble in the backcourt. Now kicks it ahead to Malik Weed. Weed drives inside. His shot is short. And there's Williams with a rebound for Ashville. 140. All that's left in this one as the clock continues to wind down. There's a three by Huckabee. It is short. Caldwell with the rebound. And one more time for Whiteside.
Second flush in a row for Whiteside.
Cornut dribbling out high, almost a turnover. Three-pointer is up and no good. There's Weed with the weak side rebound for the Bears, and Lincoln wants to run once more, up by 23. Hemp Hill for three. Yes.
Hit every part of the rim and fell through. Hemp Hill getting that shooter's touch, shooter's roll.
26-point lead now as Cater with 50 seconds to go. The Bears and White Plains tomorrow night. You'll be able to see that game right here on FNN. It's the nightcap tomorrow evening of round two. Cornett for three. The Bears the other way. Ball last touched by Cater. 29 seconds to go. And day one will be in the books.
Recapping earlier action, Westbrook Christian defeated Moody 69-62. Winterboro goes down to Pell City 42-41, and White Plains defeats Sylacauga 75-59.
And the Golden Bears have won this one. And in about 15 seconds, we can give you the final score in this contest. Right now, it's 81-55. And this game will end 81-55. Horn sounds, and this one is over, and the Lincoln Golden Bears will move on into the winner's bracket of the Lincoln Thanksgiving Invitational as they defeat Asheville here this evening 81-55. We'll be back post-game activity from Golden Bear Gymnasium after this on the Friday Night Network.
Professional Apothecary has been the Talladega area's trusted hometown pharmacy for generations. We can meet all your prescription and insurance needs. Plus, you'll find all the basic over-the-counter medications. There's a full line of support hose, and don't forget to check out our Dollar Saver Shelf. When it comes to medical supplies, Professional Apothecary has you covered. You'll find everything from mobility needs to home and portable oxygen, CPAP equipment and supplies, easy lift chairs, and a full line of Dr. Comfort shoes.
Merry Christmas from Professional Apothecary.
Just off the square in Talladega.
The Calhoun County Commission, made up of J.D. Hess, Tim Hodges, Fred Wilson, Don Hudson, and Lee Patterson, ask you to take a look at what Calhoun County has to offer. With our beautiful parks, neighborhoods, recreational facilities, historic sites, and museums, our citizens enjoy a high quality of life and strongly supports the arts. If you're considering expanding or starting a new business, take a look at what Calhoun County has to offer. You'll be glad you did.
81-55, our final score here tonight from the Lincoln Thanksgiving Tournament. Lincoln, the host school on top, winning tonight. Now join me, Coach Rush Rutledge. And Coach, jumped out to a pretty big lead there in that first quarter, finishing the half 45-24. Asheville made their way back into somewhat of a game there, cutting it to, I think, under 15 there in the fourth quarter. But your bunch able to extend that lead back out in the fourth quarter. Talk about the game here tonight.
Well, I think we got after it a little bit and got that big lead and just kind of just got relaxed. And then just didn't defend like we were supposed to. And they got back. They shot the ball well from the outside. I mean, I don't think they missed many. And so that got them back in the game. But, I'm not real pleased with the way we defended tonight, especially in the half-court set. I think we played well. We pressed well. We got to the point, we got that lead, and just went through the motions a little bit, and it kind of got them back in the game.
Facing a tough team in White Plains tomorrow night. You saw White Plains play earlier tonight, defeating Sylacauga 75-59. A team much like yours, experienced team, likes to push the ball up and down the floor. Talk about the matchup with White Plains tomorrow in the nightcap at 8:30.
Well, it's going to be tough. They played well tonight, and we got our hands full tomorrow. Let me just tell you, they play well. Like I said, they're fundamental. We'll have to play a lot better. We'll have to defend a lot better tonight in the half-court set to beat that bunch tomorrow.
That's Coach Rush Rutledge with the Lincoln Golden Bears. Appreciate you joining us, Coach.
Thank you.
We'll be back on the air tomorrow night at 7. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, we'll recap this Lincoln-Asheville game here on FNN, the Friday Night Network.
Due to an upturn in the economy, Main Street Business Loans has pre-approved the release of millions of dollars in small business funding. Your business may already be pre-approved to receive up to $250,000. We've sent out millions of pre-approval letters. We see the economy growing, and our underwriters believe now is the time to invest in your business so you can grow faster and make more money. And we're prepared to give you $250,000 to do it. Your funds can be available in 5 days. There are no application fees, no annual fees, just quick access to up to $250,000. If your business did not receive your approval letter to get up to $250,000, call Main Street Business Loans Approval Desk now.
Call 1-800-817-3046. That is 1-800-817-3046.
Again, the Golden Bears victorious here this evening over the Asheville Bulldogs. And Jason, they jumped out to an early start, and they were really in control throughout.
Yeah, led 45-24 at the half, and finishing up 81-55, leading the way. D. Whiteside, as you see some of the highlights here during the ball game. Lincoln pretty much in control the majority of the game. End of fourth quarter, end of the third, kind of lackadaisical on defense, but Hemp Hill and company with the Lincoln Golden Bears really taking control. Hemp Hill, 16 points on the night, 4 three-pointers.
Yeah, and created a lot of offense off their defense. A full court pressure really caused a lot of problems for Asheville here this evening as the Bears move to 3-0 on the year, while Asheville drops to 1-3. Of course, both these teams will be playing tomorrow, and of course, we will be on the air at 6:45 tomorrow evening. We will be bringing you both games in the winner's bracket at 7 o'clock tomorrow night. As I said, on the air at 6:45. At 7 o'clock, it will be Pell City and Westbrook Christian in game one in the nightcap tomorrow night. And it may be standing room only here tomorrow night, Jason, for White Plains and Lincoln.
Should be a good crowd. Looking forward to it.
Yes, we are. The Wildcats and the Golden Bears in round two of the 2015 Lincoln Thanksgiving Invitational. So that is going to do it for day number one this evening. Thanks for joining us. For Jason Pommen, I'm Jeff Ellison. Good night from Lincoln.